get some. Well, here it is, Duke Nukem Forever, my number 5 off the underappreciated video. If you haven't checked it out yet, here's a link to that video. I know, go watch it. I know you want to watch it.
I worked for the company of GameStop at the time when I was one of the 4 that showed up for the midnight release to pick up Duke Nukem Forever. I grabbed the Balls of Steel edition, which came with the Duke Bust, along with grabbing the special edition strategy guide. Where do I start with the Duke? He originally made his debut on the PC in 1991 under the title Duke Nukem. Then the sequel came out in 1993. These were side-scrolling shooter adventure series, which are available on Steam now if you ever want to check them out. Then Duke became infamous with Duke Nukem 3D in 1996. It was originally released on the PC and damn near ported everywhere. MS-DOS, Game.com, Mac, Saturn, PlayStation, N64, Genesis, Xbox Arcade, Windows, Android, Linux, PS3, and Vita. Damn, that's a lot of ports. It was a mega hit, selling over 3.5 million copies. So, why did everyone enjoy this game so much? Well, it came out around the time when being a violent first-person shooter wasn't new, with Wolfenstein 3D already beating them to the punch in 92. However, it was a hit, more than likely due to the repugnant nature of the Duke himself. He would shout out vulgar obscenities at the pig cops, along with tipping strippers to wiggle their pixelated titties at the player. Duke was so damn appreciative of himself and his greatness that you would consider him to be one of the biggest douchebags in the world if you ever ran across him in real life. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is why we love him. April 28th, 1997, Duke Nukem Forever was announced. It was released June 2011. It has been stated on numerous occasions that it was a development nightmare to get this game to see the light of day. It seemed that the team behind Duke Nukem just kept changing software and graphical engines, trying to keep up with the times while developing their dream child into existence. So rumors and speculations arose, teaser trailers of the project came to light, but then were removed from the final product. Everyone was talking about when is Duke Nukem Forever coming out. It became a gamer joke throughout the community of if it would ever arise. Though it never lost its steam amongst the fans, for when the trailer of the game came out for the final time, everyone was excited to finally see Duke back and get the game they were waiting for the last 15 years. There, right there is why this game was doomed from the start. 15 years of buildup, 15 years of hype, 15 years of speculation. There's no way any sort of perspective that this game would be successful. It's unfortunate. It really is. The gaming community was introduced to Halo, Gears of War, Modern Warfare, and other first-person shooters that were just far beyond what Duke was. There were already these incredible games that had pushed the limits of shooters. Now people were going to compare those games to Duke Nukem. But here's the catch. Duke Nukem isn't something to be compared to by any other retrospect. He is who he is. Duke Nukem in his vocabulary is the same guy in Duke Nukem Forever as he was in Duke Nukem 3D. Granted, him only having 2 guns to equip and solve little puzzles here and there, along with the mini RC games, feels out of place. It's a legitimate irritation that you don't have an entire arsenal to work with whenever you want to. On top of that, you can only kill bosses with explosives, which almost guarantees you will use one of your slots to hold a rocket launcher. I'm sure you've seen plenty of these complaints about the execution of this game, so I will leave the generic complaints to a minimum. The weird thing is, most of my favorite games are glitched and have numerous gameplay issues. But the game is ultimately enjoyable thanks to Duke himself. The character drives the game. Mechanics can suck, but hearing Duke boast his one-liners will always crack a chuckle, or at the very least, a genuine smirk. John St. John returns to bring the man himself back to life, and it is glorious. There is so many things about this game visually that's enjoyable. I get it, the graphics are kind of dated, but you know what? I don't give a shit!
So yeah, when we were talking about our top 5 underappreciated games, I found it surprising they actually mentioned Duke Nukem Forever. Now, I remember playing this game very, very little when it first came out, and honestly, I wasn't too impressed. And especially since I was expecting a lot more out of it, you know, from all the hype that was surrounding it. But after actually playing it again recently, I would actually have to agree with you. Now, it's not the greatest game ever, and it definitely didn't live up to the hype, but when you actually sit back and let the game be itself, you know, let Duke Nukem be Duke Nukem. It's pretty good. It's nothing groundbreaking for sure, but the comedy's there, the gameplay is solid, and yeah, to be honest, I actually haven't gotten around to beating the game yet. I'm still working on it, but from what little I played, I don't understand all the hate surrounding it, you know, unless it gets really, really bad near the end of the game, but you know.
So yes, you can easily be one of those mainstream critics that hates the game for not living up to your expectations. But for me, as a kid, I remember playing with Duke Nukem 3D at my friend's house and just enjoying how this guy was letting you play a game like a real man, treating you like a man. You're not a boy when you play this game. To me, I got to play with my childhood friend again, and that's why I love Duke Nukem Forever. Thanks, Gearbox, for letting Duke come out to play. I had fun. I had fun playing with my friend again. I implore you to give this game a second chance.
Hello out there, it's me, Duke, here to remind you to subscribe to Nocktunes. Otherwise, I may have to rip off your head and shit down your neck. Hail to the king, baby.
Holy crap. Yeah, that was John St. John doing the voice of Duke telling you all to subscribe to Nocktunes. Holy shit, I really didn't think he was gonna do it when I sent him the email. Thank you, John, for doing that. That was freaking phenomenal. I also want to give a little bit of a shout out to Clint from Lazy Game Reviews. He was volunteering his time to do an impression of Duke. John actually got to it before he did, so fortunately I had to pass on the impression. But man, oh, that was so freaking cool. Anyways, don't forget to like and comment as well as subscribing. I want you guys to share this video with your friends. Let me know what you think about it. Any suggestions for videos in the future. We're going strong with doing these top fives and segueing them into reviews. So we're going to keep going with that. So the next one is going to be Kevin's number five for the review. So stick around for that one and, catch you guys later. Thanks. Oh, shit. Damn. Almost forgot. Patreon. Don't forget to go to Patreon and see if you're up for donating $1 a month. Helps out the show. And just, yeah, goddamn, still forget. John St. John, man, shit.